Blackstone presents The Politically Incorrect Guide to Pandemics by Stephen W. Mosher. This book is read by John McLain. I dedicate this book to my 9 children and 12 grandchildren and counting, in the hope that they may never again have to endure a man-made pandemic. Introduction. The Plague Village of Haminmanga, China, circa 3000 BC. The bodies were piled helter-skelter. Almost 100 corpses had been hastily thrown into a small house, which was then burned to the ground, and the village itself was abandoned. Fire was the chief purifying agent of primitive man. The village was located in China's northeast, a vast area stretching from just north of Beijing all the way to the Amur River, which marks the border with Russia. Haminmanga, as it is called today, was excavated in 2011 by a team of Chinese anthropologists who wrote in the journal Chinese Archaeology that it was the largest and best preserved prehistoric settlement site found to date in northeast China. Altogether, the researchers discovered the foundations of 29 houses, but one in particular caught their attention. The house, which consisted of a single 14 by 15 foot room, was filled with human bones. The 97 bodies had been stacked 2 and 3 high, suggesting that the deaths had taken place so quickly that there was no time for them to be properly buried. Half were children, the others were adults, not a single one was over 30. After considering a number of different scenarios, including warfare and earthquakes, the anthropologists concluded that the large death toll might have been caused by a plague in the Horkan Sandy Land in northeast China 5,000 years ago. The outbreak does not seem to have been restricted to Haminmanga, judging from the existence of another mass burial site dating from the same time. A couple hundred miles away lies Miaozhengao, which was excavated some years earlier. The skeletons unearthed there were the same age as the Haminmanga victims and had been piled together in similar fashion. As in Haminmanga, something had happened in Miaozhengao that killed a lot of people in a hurry and led the survivors to abandon the spot as accursed. The Great Breeding Ground of Epidemics. It is perhaps fitting that the earliest known epidemic for which we have archaeological evidence swept across northeastern China 5,000 years ago. It was a precursor of things to come. Genomic analyses have shown that smallpox, the bubonic plague, and multiple deadly influenzas, including the Spanish flu, actually originated in China. It was for good reason that Francis Gasquet called China the great breeding ground of epidemics over 100 years ago in his book about the bubonic plague, The Black Death of 1348 and 1349. Identifying the cause of the disaster. This similarity between the two sites may indicate that the cause of the Haminmanga site disaster was similar to that of the Miaozhengao sites. Authors Yonggang Zhu and Ping Ji wrote, that is, they both possibly relate to an outbreak of an acute infectious disease. But if an epidemic devastated the entire region, what disease caused it? Chinese scientists are unable to give a clear answer to the question of what killed the residents of Haminmanga and other settlements up to hundreds of miles away. It could have been smallpox, which in one form or another plagued humanity for at least 10,000 years until it was eradicated a few decades ago. We know from written records that practitioners of traditional Chinese medicine have been grappling with deadly strains of smallpox since well before the birth of Christ. By 200 BC, as we will see in Chapter 1, they had already invented an early form of vaccination called variolation, to protect people against the disease. Smallpox is certainly deadly enough to have killed half the population of Haminmanga, a death toll so high it may have led the survivors to burn the victims' remains and flee the village in horror. But there is an invisible killer, even deadlier than smallpox, that may have struck Haminmanga. This would be the same disease that was responsible for three of the greatest pandemics in recorded history: the Plague of Justinian, the Black Death, and the Yunnan Plague, the bubonic plague. All three plagues, each of which eventually made its way west, can be traced back to major epidemics in China. But the Chinese Empire also endured many other outbreaks over the course of time.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.